Khalil Ibrahim was considered one of Khartoum's most powerful opponents in Darfur. Now the Sudanese army say they've hunted him down.
تمكنت القوات المسلحة في صباح اليوم الباكر.
The Sudanese army managed in the early hours of today to kill the rebel Khalil Ibrahim in the state of North Kordofan. He was trying to infiltrate the state of South Sudan to regroup his troops there. But our troops surrounded him in the local area. He entered that area yesterday and attacked civilians and killed some of them, kidnapping some women and children. Our troops rushed to the area and surrounded the rebel groups and killed some of them with their leader, Khalil Ibrahim.
Ibrahim was behind the two main attacks that defined the Darfur conflict. The attack on Al-Fashir Airport in 2003, in which a number of Sudanese military aircraft were destroyed, setting off the beginning of the conflict. The second was his attack on the Sudanese capital in 2008.
This is the city of Omdurman, just across the river from Khartoum. In 2008, Khalil Ibrahim's heavily armed militias reached this point, trying to march on the presidential palace, which is only about 5 kilometers from here, before they were crushed by the Sudanese army.
Ibrahim's declared policy was the complete overthrow of the Sudanese government as the only way to end the struggle in Darfur. For several years, he refused to negotiate, and when he finally signed a few deals with Khartoum, he soon backed down. He was supported by part of the Zagawa tribe he belonged to, and also, allegedly, by the Islamist movement led by Hassan Turabi. But Ibrahim's main support came from neighboring Chad and Libya, where he found refuge. After Libyans overthrew Muammar Gaddafi, Ibrahim sneaked back into Sudan.
Most of the Justice and Equality Movement commanders were killed during the fighting in Libya, and that has weakened them. And the biggest aftermath of Gaddafi's fall is this relative calm that we see in Darfur.
Now, with Ibrahim killed, the Sudanese say they hope a negotiated solution in Darfur could be more likely than ever before. Mohammed Val, Al Jazeera, Khartoum.